Hi, Chris here from Talk Tours. I'm the Talk Tour Tour Leader, which is easy for me to say, not. Quick video just to basically show you how I prepare for a tour. Lots of customers ask what to bring, what do you do with your bike, etc. So I thought I'd share what I personally do. It's not set in stone. You feel free to do whatever you want to do, but I'll just basically run through a routine. Now, we're off to Wales tomorrow morning, so ideal opportunity. I'll start from scratch. I will be prepping my BMW S1000 XR, which will be cleaning, installed in the comms, pre-ride safety checks such as tyres, oil, that sort of stuff. Then I'll move on to what communications I use. I'm lucky enough to have a BMW, so it's got a really good TFT screen which connects to your smartphone and to your helmet set, so you can receive phone calls, you can talk to other riders, you can play music, you can do a lot of things using that. So I'll show you that, and then I'll take you through what luggage I take and what I carry in terms of tools and pumps and that type of stuff, what clothing I wear on the bike, and then I'll finish off with what sort of items to take with you to pack for the evenings. And the tip there, and it's a good tip, one I learned very early on in my touring career: pack light, less is more. You really do not need to pack a lot of kit, because when you think about it, most of our tours, you're actually sat on the bike for a high percentage of the day, so you've only really got to bring enough clothing for a couple of hours in the evening, 2 or 3 hours, whatever, or if you're a party animal, all night, who knows. But yeah, I'll go through that. I'll do it all step by step. Don't mean to insult anybody's intelligence. If I do anything that you don't agree with, just let me know in the comments below, and hope you enjoy the video.
Okay, so here's the first stage in the process.
Bike cleaning.
May not look dirty, but it is. So that's the first thing I'm going to do. Give her a good old...
Okay, so that's the cleaning done. I'll probably finish it off by polishing it and using some silicone spray around the engines, etc., but I'm not going to bore you with that. One of the advantages of cleaning a bike before you go on tour is, because you're so close up and personal with it, you can spot anything that might be wrong: a loose brake hose, or cracking your tyre, or nailing your tyre, or anything like that. You generally spot it, so it's worth doing. Just from that point of view. But I also like to have a clean bike. Adios for now. Okay, so bike's clean. I've not spotted anything that needs any urgent attention while I was cleaning it. So what I do next is, I'm a member of the Essex Advanced Motorcycle Group, and the practice that they apply is what's in this book, which is the Police Motorcycle Roadcraft, and that is the skill and the level that we're trained to follow. I've completed the course. I've reached the dizzy heights of Rossborough Gold, and as part of that process, it's got a pre-ride checklist. I won't go through it all with you, but basically make sure you've got enough petrol, check your oil. My oil is down here, and I can see it probably won't come out. I'm on a flat level surface on the center stand, and I can check and I can see it's between the levels. Radiator water, again, might not come out, but through there I can see they're between the maximum and minimum levels. Then your chest, all your lights,
So basically, let me just turn it on, give everything a little test. It's all coming up. You need to test your headlights. Again, they are on. You probably won't come out in the camera, but the LED day running lights are on. Test all your indicators, front and rear. Make sure they're all working. Again, front and rear. Make sure your horn's working. Headlight flash is working, etc. What does it say from there? And then you obviously, you need to check your tyre pressures. I won't do that on camera. Standard tyre pressures for most of the bikes I've ever owned is 42 psi rear and 36 psi front. But go buy your own bike, your own tyre, because they vary. And sometimes it's open to personal preference as well. Some people like the tyres a little bit softer, some people don't. And then you just basically run through all the things on this book: steering, suspension, etc. Test your brakes, have a look at your brake disc pads, which again you can't really see on the camera, but I can see. I can see there's plenty left in them, and do the same with the rear. Check your chain. I've got the benefit of a maintenance free chain on this, which is you're supposed to not have to lubricate or adjust it. Time will tell. I'm not convinced about that yet, but we'll see. Jury's still out. And that's it for the pre-safety tip. So I'm going to talk you through my comms very quickly. Nothing fancy. So on my crash helmet I have the Cardo Pack Torque Bold, which is both DMC, so dynamic mesh connection, and Bluetooth. You can connect so many riders on the mesh system, create groups so you can all talk to each other, providing you've got a Cardo or a headset of some description. They're compatible with most. The most difficult thing is working out how to use it. You need a degree in rocket science on some of these things. So walking around the bike, so that's how I communicate with other riders. And then two navigation methods. I've got TomTom up the top here, which I use for any GPX rides that I've imported for the tour. You'll see on the Wales tour, I go into my routes. We've got all of the various options that I can take: Ponderosa Cafe Loop, Wrexham Loop, Mould Loop, whatever. And then I also use an app called Calimoto on my mobile phone. That tends to create some really good twisty routes. If I'm going somewhere I've not been before, I'll have a look at what Calimoto says. And I also use TomTom to record any rides, so if they're any good, I can save them. So that the phone all links up with the TFT screen there. Which then gives me options to use the telephone. So I've got all of the different numbers stored in there on my last calls, etc. So fairly standard. I've got media, which gives me the option of playing music. Got some good headphones with the Cardo Pack Talk JBL speakers. You've even got a very basic navigation system built into it as well, which hooks off of a BMW app on your mobile phone. And that's basically it in a nutshell. That's all I use. None of it's essential, especially on one of our tours, because we use the drop-off system. So you don't actually have to have any of your own navigation system if you don't want to. What we do, we use an app called Life 360 on the mobile, which tells me where you all are by GPS. So if any of you get lost and dropped off, I can go and find you. We can also make sure that you're safe. If we can see you moving, we know that there's a reasonable chance that you're safe. You can hear the crasher. I'm talking like my next turn on there. I don't know what else to say. The panniers. Okay, so in these panniers I will have, I haven't got the key with me, but I'll have inner liners. And the reason for that is when I get to a hotel, if we've had a particularly nasty weather, your panniers, your side panniers, tend to get covered in mud and rubbish, which means you're then bringing them into the hotel room or whatever. So if you have the inner bags, you just literally leave the panniers on the bike. They're nice and secure, they're all locked on. And then you don't have that worry. You can just take the inner bags out and then leave the panniers on, job done. So the next thing I'll show you is what I actually carry in the top box, so be right back. Okay, so this is what I carry in the top box. I carry probably more than most people do because I'm trying to cater to all of our customers as well. Minor breakdowns, loose nuts, loose chains, that type of stuff. I'd rather be able to deal with them at the roadside myself or provide the tools to the owner, who can then carry out minor repairs themselves. It just saves the group being split up, saves them having to call out breakdown services, etc. And just to have the basics with you. I can't carry out a full service or anything, but I could probably get us out of most bits of trouble. The only thing I'm missing that I need to add, and I'll probably buy that tomorrow morning or later on this afternoon, is a petrol siphoner. Not so important in the UK, but when I'm abroad in the Alps, the last thing you want is for someone to run out of fuel at the top of a mountain. So you can pinch some fuel out of a GS. They've always got the most biggest tanks, so you'll always find some petrol in one of those. So that's got to be added. So basics, what I've got, I'll just go through it very quickly, which is a puncture repair kit. Yeah, get a puncture at the roadside. You can basically plug them. I won't show you how to use it. That's not what this is about. You plug them with these little plugs. They go into a hole. As long as it's not in the sidewall, that will get you home. Or get you to a tyre repair shop, tyre specialist to replace the tyre. But they're pretty good final repairs. I know some people actually leave them and carry on using the bike. Personally, I wouldn't, but that's up to personal choice. Next, I've got a portable pump, battery, USB powered. Apparently, it inflates about 15 tyres on one charge. It's got a pressure gauge built into it, if that comes out on there, so you can preset your PSI or your bar or whatever. So once I've repaired the puncture at the roadside, I can then inflate your tyre and get you going again. Gaffer tape is brilliant. It fixes just about anything that hangs off your bike that you haven't got the right bolts and screws for, so always have a roll of gaffer tape, fairly standard. That is personal to my bike. It fits the rear wheel spindle, so I can carry out any repairs, chain problems, etc. And then in my roll bag, this all rolls up nice and neatly. I've got a variety, cable ties, multi-tool thing here, which it's got pliers, screwdrivers, the likes, Allen keys, a variety of spanners, I forget what they're called for the nuts and bolts on a BM. They're all that I think they are called Torx, something like that. Socket spanners, and this is a special tool for the BMW as well. Fits most of the screws that hold the fairings on, etc. And then I've got a voltmeter as well, which tells me if you've got any electrical problems, whether your alternator is actually putting a charge through your battery or not. And that is basically it for the bike. So just summarising, we did a cleaner, we did a pre-ride safety checks, we make sure we've got the tools on board, we make sure we've got a tank of petrol, we have all the navigation set up. One thing I didn't mention is the phone, because it's using GPS, it does use a lot of battery. So I have a USB connector here, feeds into my tank bag, hay fever tablets as well, essential for this time of year, and there's a power bank there that powers the supply, and I just charge that when I get back to the room each night. You could, if you chose to, on a BMW, you've got a power socket there, so I could feed it from there, but it's just a bit messy with the wires, so I choose to do it this way. Just make sure you've got your tools, etc. And that's it for the bike. So the next bit will be, I'll show you what I take, what I wear, in the next instalment. Cheers. Okay, so this is what I wear, or will be wearing on the bike. As I said in the introduction, little is more. Pack the bare essentials. The key to that, I find, is merino wool. Merino wool is from a sheep that is raised in New Zealand and will keep you warm and it will keep you cool. And the joy of it is it has an antibacterial property to it, which means that you can literally wear this, and I wear the tops and the leggings all day, every day riding. You can sweat in it all day long, hang it up overnight, it dries and it does not smell. And I can testify that. I wore it every day in Austria, sweated, it was 30 plus degrees every day and it didn't smell. And all you need to do, if it gets to the point where you think I want to wash it, just rinse it under the tap and it's dry in an hour at the most. So that's the key. So you don't have to pack loads of different t-shirts and stuff every day. And I literally just over the top of that, for this trip I'm going to wear my textiles, which is a Alpine Star. It's they're waterproof. You've got the top, so I've got matching trousers that go with them, completely waterproof. If it gets much above 23, 24 degrees, they're too hot. So I've got another set of clothing that I wear. I wear some waterproof BMW jeans and a Knox Zephyr, which is a mesh jacket, which is really good. But as we're going to Wales, the forecast, the highest temperature is about 23 degrees. So, and you never know in Wales, because it's mountainous, it could rain off and on. It might not rain at all, who knows, but at least I'm wearing this kit. I'm prepared. I haven't got to stop and change and put waterproofs on, etc., because they are waterproof. The other thing I can just sort of say, this is quite handy, which is a multi adapter. So basically you just have one plug in the mains. The rest of this one's got seven USB connections, seven leads, so I get my GoPro, my iPhone, my Cardo, what else, oh yeah, my power bank, the battery power bank, all off one plug. So there's no searching around for hundreds of plugs in the hotel. Plug it in, job done. And then these are the inner bags that go in my side panniers. They don't look particularly big on here, but believe you me, they open up. They've got expansion on the side, pockets on the side. They're completely waterproof as well, although the panniers themselves are waterproof. So all I do is when I arrive at the hotel, I undo the panniers, take the bags in, leave the panniers on the bike. And that's it. Thanks for watching. If you want to add any comments, add them below. Like I said at the start, this isn't a definitive guide. This is what I do. All I'd say above and beyond what I've just said is, for the evening, I'm just going to take the usual sort of few pairs of socks and underwear each day, and then for the evening I'll probably just pack a pair of jeans, a couple of tops and my wash kit, and that's about it. It fits in there nicely. So remember, less is more. Thanks for watching. Catch you on tour.